Our station, our talent, our people.
Die Dang Rugby.
Welcome to the leading internet radio station in the Mother City. There are many ways to stream our shows. Visit us on our Facebook page, live at Radio East River. Also, visit us on our website, www.radioeastriver.co.za, or download the Radio East River app, available and supported on any and all smart devices. Radio East River, die ding rug hier.
Radio Eerste Rivier, onze stasie, onze talent, onze mensen. WhatsApp ons bij 064-536-9095. Talk to us, die ding ruk hier.
Okay, so you must say, come on. Can you feel it? Say, can you feel it? Yeah, bro. Can you feel it? Say, yeah, bro. One time. Can you feel it? Say, yeah, bro. Come on. 1, 2, shut it down. 2, 3, 4, 5, go.
is rukkie.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Die ding rukkie.
Welcome to Radio Eastern of Cape Town's leading internet radio station. Good afternoon, goeiemiddag, doemalang, asani bonani, morweni, assalamu alaikum, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahoy, salutas, salutas, awe, 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 amalilike mense van Kaapstad en beyond. Welcome to Radio Eastern of Cape Town's leading internet radio station. Jy is ingeskakeld by die Business Hub, live met die Business Preacher, the only show in South Africa, wat is certified license it, of course, om Engels te praat. 0645369095 is die WhatsApp line. As jy wil jou stem op ons radiostasie, luister seer voor sy 0645369095. Stuur vir sy boodskapie, die voice note, en dan speel jou stem live op Radio Eesterwe. We are ending off this month with Chelsea Stachy. Ons gaan vir haar het vandag wat vir Mitsus Plein Entrepreneurs Hub gaan kom represent vandag. Sy is die eienaar van Chelsea Bykit and Nailed It. She will be with us today celebrating entrepreneurship, motivating and uplifting the spirit of entrepreneurship today. So definitely it has been a great month for the month of July featuring Mitsus Plein Entrepreneurship Hub. We are also going to have Lucrisa Giardini via a phone call on in studio. We have Mustachi live in the atelier vandag. So she's live in the atelier vandag. She will be joining us in a minute just after the motivation device and song. And of course 11 minutes after 1 o'clock, die 25ste van die 7de maand 2024. Ek wil net vir die 25ste se mense sê, vir die wat weet waar ons praat, be safe, spend safe, and just be safe. 0645369095 is die WhatsApp line as jy ingeskakel is. Ek wil net gauw vandag se motivational quote vir ons lees, voor ek ons motivational song toe gaan vandag. Ek kry dit nou nie op my phone nie, but anyway, I know it by heart. It's a quote from one of the philanthropists, one of the great businessmen that I like and follow, Warren Buffett, the philanthropy, the guy that is great when it comes to investment strategies. He says, "You do not have to be smarter than everyone or anyone. You just have to be more disciplined than anyone and everyone." So my motivation for you today is be more disciplined instead of trying to be the smartest in the room. 064-536-9095 is that WhatsApp line. You are tuned in to Radio Eesterwe, Cape Town's leading internet radio station. And of course, you can now, all our shows are recorded and available as podcasts for you to listen at any time. All you need to do is search Radio Eesterwe one word on all podcasting sites, including Spotify, YouTube, Deezer, etc. And of course, to advertise with us, you can send us an email to admin@radioeesterwe.co.za. One of my most favorite songs as a motivation songs playing for you today is Caitlin Philander, a young dame daar van die Suidkus, met hou net 'n rukkie aan. Soos ek altyd vir julle sê, moenie motivational songs, moenie luister na die beat. Do not get captivated with the beat, but get captivated and let the words illuminate your intention and mindset today. Playing for you, hou net 'n rukkie aan. Local is lekker, en soos ons by Radio Eesterwe sê, hashtag local is global. Met hou net 'n rukkie aan, wees sterk stanna nana, en wees sterk stanna papa. Stay tuned and listen to the motivation song for this hour as we are welcoming in Chelsea Stachy. This is Radio Eesterwe, Cape Town's leading internet radio station.
Our station, our talent, and our people.
Dis vir jou wat in die aardle nou, jy is gestak en in die smag om te verdwijn. Ey, kijk jou, ek weet hoe jy voel, ek weet as baie wat jy question en ek weet jy is moeg, maar ga na aan my broer. Blijf, ek heb net moed, kijk voor en toe, dan gaan beter, raak hou nog een rukkie aan. Kijk jy, ek weet die stuk en ek verstaan jou point, ek weet van jou suicide moet wat jy altijd skryf. En ek weet, dis nie maklik om elke dag gereed te soek om lewendig te bly, maar ek weet hoe jy voel. Jy droom ek dinge wat jy nie redig van praat Van jy voel dis worthless Van niemand sal jou verstaan Gedagtes wat jou laat en lip draai jy nie aan En jy voel jy die krag om nog een dag voor te gaan Maar nog steeds staan jy op Jy sit een smal op jou gezicht Probeer jou beste om mense te convins Dat jy oké is Dat jy redig hippie is Maar om te weet jy draag jy die hele wereldse gevig Jou hart is hier en nie bevraag jouself Like hoe gaan jy hier oorkom Hoe gaan jy dit uitmaak Maar ek weet die sterk hou nog een rukkie Ja en dinge gaan beter raak Ey, dis vir jou wat in die aand leen Jy is so stik in die smag om te verdwijn Ey, kijk ek het jou Ek weet hoe jy voel Ek weet as baie wat jy question En ek weet jy is moeg Maar ga na het my broer Blijf skip net moed Kijk voor en toe Dinge gaan beter, ek hou nog een rakkie aan Dis vir jou wat in jy aand leen Jy is so stak in die slag om te verdwijn Ey, kijk ek het jou, ek weet hoe ek voel Ek weet dat baie wat jy question en ek weet jy smoke Maar ga na aan my broer Blijf skip net moed Kijk voor en toe Dinge gaan beter, ek hou nog een rukkie aan Ik geloof aan jou Ik geloof aan jou God gaan jou Ik ga aan jou Ey, ey, ey Ey, dis vir jou wat in die aand leen Ey, so stak in die smag om te verdwijn Ey, kijk ek het jou, ek weet jy is moeg Ek weet as baie wat jy question en ek weet jy is moeg Maar ga na aan my broer Blijf skip net moed Kijk voor en toe Dinge gaan beter, ek hou nog een rakkie aan
Radio Eerste Rivier Onse stasie, onse talent Onse mense, WhatsApp ons by 064-536-9095. Talk to us, die ding ruk hier.
064-536-9095 is that WhatsApp line if you are tuned in. Welcome back to Radio Easter of Cape Town's leading internet radio station. I hope that you have enjoyed the show today, or the motivational song today. Yo, what a beautiful song. What an inspirational song. So ja, ons het ons gas in die atelier vandag hier so. Chelsea. Chelsea. Zeg het recht.
Hier het
reg gesê. Ah, nee, Chelsea. Sy sê, ek moet dit met Engelse flavor sê, Chelsea.
Net vir vandag.
Net vir vandag, okay. So Chelsea, welcome to the studio. Ons is blij om vir jou te vandag hier. We are happy to have you here today. I hope that you are also happy to be here.
I'm happy to be here. I'm quite excited and nervous at the same time.
As het, hulle sê, nerves is een goeie ding hoor. Nou, dit is een baie goeie ding. So, not to waste any time, 18 minutes after 1 o'clock, kan jy gauw vir jou gauw net voorstel daar aan die gasten?
So, my name is Chelsea. I'm 25 years old. I'm from Goodwood, Cape Town. And I have been an entrepreneur for as long as I can remember. It was just now recently that I turned into something more. But other than that, it's something that I looked into when I was still in school. I was in high school. I was dabbling into a lot of things. I was doing cake. I was doing makeup. I did nails. And it just got to a point where I needed to do something more. So I know that when we're in school, we tend to believe or we are taught that we need to... obviously, immediately after school, you need to go and study, you need to go and work, but sometimes you've got a skill. And when you have a skill, it's more about doing things that can build onto that. And I didn't realize that. So after high school, I ended up studying. I studied fashion, and I graduated. But I realized that it's not something that was making me happy.
Of course.
So I had to look within myself. I think it was 2020. And then I realized that maybe fashion just isn't my passion. It could be somebody else's passion, but it wasn't mine. And I wasted time. And then I know when we're at home and we're young, we become very demotivated because you see your friends, you study now, I'm a doctor, and exit nobody else. So it becomes demotivating, and it got to a point where one of my friends from East River suggested that I do a course. And I said, okay, I just studied, so well, that must no need be a duni.
Of course, yeah.
To seek it for myself, let me just take the chance and give it a go.
So. And
next thing I know, I'm at Art Labs in Mitchell's Plain, and I'm doing a course online, a business course, to build me up. Ik weet as a mens dink, you know everything, maar het is net nie soos het voorkom nie. En toe besef ek, that there's so much that I need to still learn, there's so much that I need to grow, there's so much that I need to adapt to. At the time, I started Chelsea Baked It, so it was a registered business. I was doing cakes for my family and for my friends, but I wasn't getting paid.
Mm.
And so I told myself, wait, if there's something that I can do to upskill myself or help me in this industry, I will take it. Next thing I knew, that the course that I did at Art Labs, it was completely free. All that I needed to do was just attend and focus and listen in and have that drive. And because I knew that what I was doing, baking, was something that intrigued me, something that kept me going, something that I was excited to do. And because I had the support from my family and my friends, it made a huge difference. But also, what I encountered was is the community in Mitchell's Plain. The support that I received from them was unmatched.
Yes.
And I said to myself, for what it's worth, for what it's worth, I know that this is exactly where I need to be. And other than that, from there, I did the course. I met Lucretia, Giardini. And from there, things changed for my businesses.
Okay.
It became one business and it turned to businesses.
Okay. Kom ons kom gou aan 'n very, very, very great, inspiring resume. Is dit resume? Chelsea, laat ek vandag my beste Engels uit die kas uit gaan haal, hoor. Sit my laat mooi verstaan, meneer, asseblief.
Uit die booster
uit. Oeh, en jy die beste Afrikaans saamgebring. So, you spoke about something which intrigued me. Doing something, en ek weet, miskien klink het soos een ding oor en oor sê, so, but it's important that everybody, that people needs to understand that you have to do something that you passionately like. You love it, because soos baie great and brilliant and successful established entrepreneurs say, hulle sê, if the profit is not going to keep you going, it's definitely going to be the passion that will fuel you to reach to your next level. How important is it for you, especially as a young entrepreneur, wat soveel ek gepraat van jou vriende wat gaan studeer, it sometimes people tell us, hello, gaan kry a real job, because they do not believe that entrepreneurship is the best and the biggest real job that you can actually get. Het vat maar net langer om maar uit te kom. How important is it to be a person of passion, you know, to love what you do, you know, and to first fall in love what you do before you get to a point to be profitable?
So I'm glad that you asked that question. So there was someone that told me that my passion is not going to pay the bills. And it hit me like a ray, because to hear that, and that's coming from a family friend, and I saw what that person was doing. I had no liquor job, and he's not passion, he's paying the bills. So I said, for what it's worth to me is, I had to look within myself. What is something that I can sit up doing at 4 in the morning?
Sure.
And for sommige mense is it miskien om games te speel. Okay, then fine, maybe gaming is your passion. Maar ek het vir myself gesê, en ek vir my ouers ook in my familie gesê, you know, at the end of the day, it means that doing something personalized for someone else is making me happy. That is what I'm passionate about. And because I have this creative talent in me, I told myself, let's not limit that. At the end of the day, yes, I might have orders now this week, you know, then come January and then is it still. So I said to myself, you know what, if I can make something work, let me not limit myself on that creativity. I said, sometimes we do become demotivated based on what we hear, like your passion isn't going to pay the bills. Your passion is going to pay the bills. It can pay the bills.
Definitely.
It all has to do with mindset. So, and I believe it's also, especially with us in our, I don't know what I am, if I'm a millennial, a Gen Z, or I don't know what. But whatever I am, I know that our generation tends to get easily bored and irritated when they don't get to a point where they see money coming in. But it takes time. Rome wasn't built in a day. And at the end of the day, nothing like this is going to just magically pop up if you don't put the work in. So my advice to the next person that's starting their own business is patience. Be patient with yourself. It's something that I'm working on now. I'm not even going to tell a lie. I'm also trying to be patient with myself and patient with the process. Because patience is a... It's
a virtue.
It's a virtue.
We have a message here from a great friend and business associate of me, Mr. B from CMB Attorneys. He's saying, I'm enjoying your show, which is very inspirational. May God bless Charles's business.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So you are a living inspiration to us, Chelsea. So basically, kom ons praat gou oor vandag se you touch it. You het 'n bietjie opgeraak, you know, the generation of today. Do you think that the generation of today are more into entrepreneurship, or are they into, you know, we have AI coming up, we have you know, IT taking over the world, you know, internet opportunities taking over the world. So our youth are more into that, or they are encapsulated with what's happening on the internet and the artificial intelligence opportunities and so forth. Is entrepreneurship something that our youth are interested in? Should we as entrepreneurs do more to make them realize how much opportunities is in entrepreneurship? Can we just touch basically on that?
I'm glad you mentioned that as well. I do believe that we should continuously encourage like young entrepreneurs to continue starting, doing their own thing, starting up their own business. Because like you said, AI is out. And I picked up even now the other day just to ask AI something. Is he a mean? See? Is a robot device wat vir ons nou antwoorde gee? It's not the same. So I said, there's so much things that AI is covering. And I know that we still look at it and we still becoming a bit demotivated because why must I start my business if a robot can now do exactly what I'm doing? But still, it's maybe not going to be personalized like you would. I saw the other day I went to, I think it was Canal Walk, and I noticed that, you know, the candy floss, the people that used to stand and make candy floss? There's now a robot that's making the candy floss in the middle of the mall, a machine that's doing it. So I said, it's crazy, but still, I won't support that unless I know it's made. I want to see the person in front of me, and that for me, personally, a lot of people still prefer that. We still want to see young entrepreneurs, or we still want to see entrepreneurs, because next thing you know, if we all have the same mindset, like, ugh, there's already a machine that's doing it out of its own, then who says that person doesn't have talent and now they're sleeping on their talent because they feel a bit down because, I mean, AI has already covered it. So I feel like we as entrepreneurs should continue encouraging young entrepreneurs. I think that's also what Lucretia calls it, young entrepreneurs.
Young entrepreneurs, yes.
So I said we need to continue doing it because at the end of the day, it's not worth it sleeping on your talent. Like I said, I did baking. Somebody told me I can't do both. And regardless of me doing both, I'm still good at both.
Yes.
Can seen my nails is gedoen?
Ja, ek sien the nails is on fleek. Nails is on fleek.
Die nails is gedoen. But I said we can't also limit ourselves. I know that when you study to be have one profession, but sometimes you're good at something else. Like you are a radio talk show host. Who says you're not a mechanic at them?
Rika Bande.
Yeah,
so, and I want to touch on that because the other day myself and a friend of mine spoke and he said, and he actually, I hope he realized the power behind what he said. He said that we have to do all of these things at the same time, you know, like some of us have to do a lot of things at the same time because ons weet nog nie wat ons goed in is nie, you know. As an experienced and a learned businessman, my opinion might be a bit different. So I always say, do a lot of things at first at the same time. And then out of that 10 things, find one thing you're good at. Find one thing that you're passionate about. But do not forget about the other 9. Because even though you are passionate about one thing, that one thing might not be relevant, you understand? But then that other 9 things will keep you in the dry season. If you get what I'm trying to say. Because sometimes it's not good for you to raise 5 or 6 children at the same time. But if you raise one, then the one child can help you grow the others. From a business perspective, for example. Start, do all of the 10 things. Figure out, okay, ek is goed in die ding. Then you've put most of your effort, your energy, your resources into that one thing. Make that thing amazingly successful. And then that thing can then pour into the others. As ook belangrijk om te weet, hoekom ek sal saamstem met wat sy al sê, is my oupa het altijd gesê en my pa het altijd gesê, a man en a vrou moet nooit hulle eiers in een maandje sit nie. Is een bietjie gevaarlik.
Ek het al klaar gehoor.
So, Charles, in the future, before we call Lucrecia, before we see if we can get a hold of her, the future, government, kom ons praat gauw, from a governmental point of view, do you think that we can trust in what government has to offer for the future and for entrepreneurs? Ek weet, daar is 2 wette wat Cyril Ramaphosa eergister actually afgesign het. You understand? Wat een beetje positive nieuws gee vir small entrepreneurs or small businesses. But to come back to my question, do you think that in the future or in the new future we can depend on what in government, or should we just be pushing to be independent as we possibly can?
You? I hope no government worker is listening to me. No, I stand on being independent, because when I was thinking about it, now that you mentioned that, there was a time period I could not bake. I could not do anything because of load shedding.
Mm.
And I said, who implemented that?
Mm.
So I actually was telling a lot of my other, we were all, you know, when you start your own business, you tend to be exposed to networking.
Mm.
And we were all complaining that we couldn't do things, we couldn't work, we could do nothing. And I said, I feel that it's affecting a lot of small businesses, home businesses. We don't have generators.
Mm.
So I said that it's actually not okay now that you think about it, because now a small business cannot succeed.
Mm.
When you get to a mall, the mall is still up and running, the bank is still open.
Mm.
None of those things that affect the government stopping. It's not at a standstill. It's just us with our small businesses at home.
Exactly.
So, no, I wouldn't depend on the government. Even if they want to give like a little investment in small business owners, no.
Yeah. I think the feeling is mutual around business, small business owners, because we feel like that that government has failed small businesses. And at the end of the day, it is so scary, because entrepreneurship is the engine. Small businesses is the engine of the African economy. And if a government do not understand that, they are intentionally setting themselves up to fail. If you are not consistently and intentionally and vividly investing into the uprising and the upbuilding of small entrepreneurs and small businesses, we are setting ourselves up for fail.
Exactly.
That is why the figure of unemployment is so high. I think when we become presidents, we need to make entrepreneurs a school subject, an important thing, must.
It needs to be a factor. It needs to be implemented into school curriculums. I was lucky that I had business as a subject, but I said for those that don't have it, sometimes we, like I said, there's so much unemployment. There's so much youth that's at home that's not doing anything. And it's maybe because they don't have the correct. I won't say they don't have the skills. They have the skills. It's just they don't know how to branch these ideas out, or maybe they're not clued up with the right people or connected. Like, it was really by coincidence that I stumbled across Lucrecia, and I said, for what it's worth, the entire community, Mitchell's Plain, has been so supportive towards my business. I don't even stay in there, but I choose to be there because of how much my business has also grown and the support that I received.
Mm.
I've gone to places like Bloberg, Waterfront. I've gone to upmarket places to sell my cakes and my cupcakes, and I never sold out. The first place that I sold out was at Dagbreek Hall with Lucretia. It was my very first market. So it's a big deal for me, and it's something that I stand on, and I'll continuously tell people. You will think that, no, at the fancier places or at area or places like Waterfront, for instance, that you will get more support. Nope. I have seen people walk past me. They would rather go to Pick and Pay.
Of course.
Would rather go to Dunkin' Donuts. And I said, it's okay. It's really okay. So it is a mind over matter. There will be times where you make a good day, where a sale goes really, really great. With markets, for instance, depending on what your business is. And there will be times where it will be a really bad day. Like, I've encountered that before. And I remember there was one market I attended, and the weather wasn't the greatest. And I told Lucretia, you know what? I will see you again. Like, I'm still going to keep on doing it.
Yes.
So you must just be able to take risks. That's the other thing when you start in a business or when you're a young entrepreneur. You need to be able to take those risks and be okay with it.
Even if you're losing.
Even if you're losing. Even if it means I invested a lot of money being here, as long as I know I showed up. I turned up. It doesn't go unnoticed. There were people that walked past my stall. Maybe they just looked and they said, it's the deed for me. It's okay. Even if you're missing out on other opportunities, it's okay. It's going to happen. But as long as you are willing and able to take those risks and continuously apply yourself, I must seek my advice.
That's good. Kom ons praat gou oor you know, you've been sold out at some of the markets at Dagbreek. Kom ons praat gou oor selling, you know, selling. I've met over these years of doing business, I've met a lot of great entrepreneurs with great products. En dan klaar hulle oor een ding of they're struggling with one thing, the ability to sell. Nou, die is 'n bietjie 'n pyn, because I always tell entrepreneurs, brother, sister, if you are not able to sell, if you do not have the ability to have that sales skills, that is jy in vir a struggle. Wat doen jy? What do you do differently to ensure that your products is selling? And what should entrepreneurs do more to get their products sold, you understand? And we're not talking about marketing. Maybe we can bring some of that factors else in. But selling, you know, getting your products sold.
So I used to work in sales. I used to work in retail, and I used to work in sales, and I had to pull out a sale from any angle. So I was lucky enough to remember what I was taught at the time or what I picked up. And then I would end up, I would see people walk past me, and just now as a little tip. So in the beginning, when I sold it, I remember I took my little sister with and said, no, so oulik gelyk. And then kom die mense ons na die tafel toe van, I mean, it looks like she's also being my little salesperson. But that wasn't the point, because even though you have maybe backup or you have someone with you, they might not be able to assist you in that way.
Yes.
Or they wouldn't know what to say to the people. And then gradually, what I would do is, I started off differently at that very first market that I did in Dagbreek. And I eventually walked around, familiarized myself with all the other entrepreneurs. And as I was walking, I greeted the people. And just that simple, hello, would you like to come and see what I'm offering? It makes a huge difference. It's a little bit of a marketing strategy, you can say, or a little technique. And then you explain your offerings basically to them. And just the mere fact that you are showing interest in somebody, whether it be a simple greeting, they become, I think it's also because I did a little study on marketing. So yeah, I had to do that just that I can understand what triggers people to buy certain things. And then I would just greet and I'll be like, hi there, my name is Chelsea and I am from Chelsea Baked. Would you like to see what I have to offer you today? Or how about you come and take a look at my table? And it was just basic I won't say you have to be a people's person, because sometimes you can be an entrepreneur, start up a business, and you're not really much of a talker.
Mm.
Like, I know I'm going off topic here, but Moses wasn't able to speak.
Mm.
His brother was doing the talking.
Mm. Of course.
So, I mean, he was doing all the miracles, but someone had to be the mouth for him.
Mm.
And I said, you don't have to be a people's person, but when you realize that this is your business and you want this to work, I mean, this is your bread and butter. So if it means I need to go and say hello to that auntie over there that maybe don't want to walk this way because she's not feeling it, just go up to her and be like, hi, I hope you have a good day. And just the simple interaction with one person leads to that person coming over. And from there, when you have a business, it becomes like word of mouth. They will tell the next one, ik het nou een cupcake hier gekry. Ik het nou die donut hier gekoop. It was very nice. And it's just that simple.
Wow. Ek hoop jy het gekry daar so die awesome skills wat Chelsea saam met ons deel daar so. So leading into my almost last question before we get, I think we are ready to get Lucrecia in. But you know, it's very important, how important for you, how important is it for you as an entrepreneur to have a spiritual impact on your business or on yourself, also to have a spiritual journey with your creator as well? Because some people just think that you can do it with your natural ability, and most of the time we actually can't.
No, because
we are living because of our unnatural ability. So there is no way you can make it, you understand, without doing the necessary things spiritually, whether you pray, whether you do whatever, you know, to make sure that God is also part of your business. Like, I always remind my staff in meetings, guys, makisak wat ons doen nie, you know, we need to pray, you understand, makisak wat the strategy is, nou gaan doen nie, wat gaan ons aanvang nie, make sure that you make prayer as part of your business. How important is it that you make sure that you have a spiritual proper and solid spiritual journey, our spiritual spiritual relationship with God?
It's extremely important, because I still stand on that my business or my businesses wouldn't be anything, or it wouldn't be anywhere close to what it is right now if it wasn't for God. Like, you can go on your own understanding, but it only gets you till a certain point. There's been times where I become very, very frustrated and upset, and I tell myself, but the fact that you've got this talent or the skill is because of God. And I tend to pray over my business. I will tell the next person when they leave, they will say, God bless your business. And I say, thank you. Because at the end of the day, you also don't know who's wishing the worst behind you. Sometimes it can come from your immediate circle. And it's important to pray. Like, I know I come out of a household where my ma say anointed here van die huis, and she said on, you need to implement God in everything, whether you speak to people, before you speak to people, after you had that conversation. Even the fact that I'm here right now, the fact that this interview is even happening, it's literally God's hand. And it's because I've implemented him, and I try my best to continuously do that, even on good days. There's times where things are bad, dan wil een mens eers bid. And dan huil een mens, because it's not going well, and Lord, why is this happening to me? It's because we forget sometimes that when things are going good, then we forget to thank God. But we are very, very quick to run. So it's things like that you need to remember, and it needs to be consistent. Like I said, I need to take my own advice, because there's times where I also forget. But you don't forget to phone your friend. You need to phone God the same way. The same way I'm leaving here, and I need to thank God for the opportunity that I even managed to be here today. The opportunity that I even have skills, and I even managed to turn it into a business. It's not my own doings.
Of course.
Because of, like you said, the higher power. It's because of God.
Of course. Brilliant. We've got Chelsea Stachy in the atelier here on Radio Easter 4, Kaapstad, se gunsteling internet radio station. Rabia Rabibs voegtuned in on the comment section. Say good day, Bevan Jacobs, and everyone tuning in. I'm always kept motivated listening in. Thank you so much. We have Lucrecia Jardini saying good day, everyone. We have Rabia saying, yes, trust the process. Let's let go of our limiting beliefs and feel the fear, but do it anyway. She says, absolutely true, Bevan Jacobs, that 8 streams of income. It's a moment. Thank you for that. We have Janine Muller saying, well done, Chelsea. We have Roxanne Stoffberg there saying, I'm so proud of you, Charles, and your ventures. I wish you strength, determination, and perseverance in the face of challenges. Jesus got you. Much love, Cass. We have Rabia Vuh saying, we are spiritual beings. We are spiritual beings having all this human experience. And then we have my beautiful wife being tuned in there also saying, amazing interview, Chelsea. So you are definitely stealing people's heart here on the show.
Thank you.
Was it for Liesel Matthias ook ingeskakeld? Sy sê daar so, hi Chelsea, Alana Staghi, so proud of you.
Dat is
mijn moeder. Also, de moeder heeft een stunning lady groot gemaakt. Hoor. Well done. May God bless you. And thank you for what you are doing. Kom eens kijken of ons van Lucrecia Giardini kan inkrijgen. Samen met ons deel te van hier interview. Stay tuned to Radio Easter of Cape Town's leading internet radio station.
Our station, our talent and our people.
And Bevan and Chelsea.
Hi.
Hello, Lucrecia. Hoe gaan het vandaag?
Ja, all right. In met I en I.
Brilliant. Ik kan niet klaar. Kan jij klaar?
Nee. It's all good. How are you?
Ach ja, ja. Keeping on.
Brilliant. So, Lucrecia Giardini, we have Chelsea in the studio. So, can you give us a little bit of insight here over the dame and her bezighede?
Well, Chelsea is an amazing woman. She's very in tune with the business and people. And obviously, I met her through our networks in Mitchell's Plain. And she started at our first market last year in February with her cupcakes. I tell you, people were blown away. You know, even with the marketing, they were coming for Chelsea, you know.
Yes.
And I also feel, I mean, she's a good ambassador, you know. Mm. She just represents completely. She's doing various things like most entrepreneurs do. It's not just about having one business only most of the time. You know, we hustlers, you know what I mean? So yes. We try to focus on whatever we can that we are good at. And so she does nails as well. She's doing these awesome happy boxes that she's bringing out at the next market as well. So hope to see everyone there.
Of course. Ons gaan nou oor die market praat. So, from your side, Chelsea, so is there, what is it from your side that you want to add when it comes to Mitchell's Plain Entrepreneurship? Wat staan vir jou uit? En hoe moet die gemeenskap, you know, Mitchell's Plain Entrepreneurship gaan join?
Oh, a lot stands out. And Lucrecia will be able to back me up on this. Like I said, it was the first market that I've ever done with my business, and when I went there, I didn't know what to expect. I had absolutely no expectations. I had a lot of people telling me they don't think it's going to go really well because they don't think anybody's going to support me because I'm new. And I just told myself I would never know if I don't try. And I remember Lucrecia and I were this we met before, yes, we did, but very vaguely. So it was the first time we actually saw each other again. And she was like, you're going to have a good time. And I just told myself, if I'm going to go in this with any negative, with a negative mindset, it's really not going to work out. And then it was quiet. And at first I thought, okay, I don't know how this is going to work out. But when people started coming in, I couldn't understand how, even though it was a market, there was different people from different parts, not just of Mitchell's Plain, different parts of Cape Town that were coming in. And the way they supported as one whole community, like it means a lot to the community as well to support, not just to support local, but to support entrepreneurs.
Yes.
And it wasn't just about entrepreneurs in Mitchell's Plain. It just meant a lot to me knowing that I had that support. And it didn't even feel like now if I go to market, sometimes there are people that come regularly, it will be the same regulars. Even if I skip a market now and I skip the next one, I will still see that same uncle. It's because they love the vibe. Mm-hmm. And even though they know that I'm not from Mitchell's Plain originally, they still support as if I belong there. If myself is sick, three extra Mitchell's Plain to me.
Lucrecia, do you want to add anything on the culture of the markets? You know, I'm sensing that definitely people just need to know the culture of the market, because ik zeg altijd, man, as it remind me of die tijdse jaren, you know, the good old times. Can you remind us of the culture of the markets?
You know what, it's like very like family oriented community, you know, so it's not like any nonsense going on, touch wood, you know. And even for me, I think I might have mentioned before, I saw my aunt that I hadn't seen in 2 years, you know, my mom, them come, the senior generation, they love it, you know, and I know they're looking for more. My 80 odd year old neighbor, she said to me, wow, in her over 40 years of being in Mitchell's Plain, she's always been looking for something like this to happen, you know. So it brings people together, whether you're from the area, whether you're from other areas in Cape Town, South Africa, or the world. And I mean, we've had international people as well, you know. So it's really cool. And also to see what we have to offer, you know, that it's not like people are thinking, oh, you're coming to Mitchell's Plain and you have your own perception of it. You know, we have a space where it's safe and, yeah, you can connect, meet people, take something home with you.
Of course. You know? And the next one, when is the next one?
Okay, so the next one is happening on the 3rd of August, and our theme for August is Women's Day. So it's, yeah, we've got exciting things planned. We have a makeover competition happening as well. Chelsea will be there. So it's really exciting.
Of course, of course. And with Women's Month coming up, both you two ladies, can you just usher us into the importance of being a woman, of being a lady, and being a woman wat haar man staan? Klink nog nie lekker nie, of recht nie, but a woman wat haar woman staan of haar man staan as an entrepreneur and as a business owner. Can you usher us into what it, the importance is, wat moet voor mensen op focus, besides of them owning their space? Lucrecia, starting with you. And motivating our ladies at the same time.
You know, like, okay, so my mom, she, when we were growing up, I have sisters only, she always said to us, you know, you must be independent one day, you know, whether you have a man or husband or not, just always be independent in your life, you know. And I think for women have been, I would say, you know, it's never really been a woman's world before, you know. And, you know, men still are top in the business world and as entrepreneurs. So, I mean, I think it's very important that we inspire our women, to do like what they think they're not capable of doing. You know, and also just like, 'cause now you see, in households, it's not only the man working, women are working too, you know, or having their own businesses, seeing to the households. You know, women are the backbones of our society. So, I mean, you could say that women were the marginalized ones, you know, and still are in a lot of areas, you know. So I think it's important that it's not like we want to be like men, but you also want to have the equality that we are capable of making as much money as what men do, you know.
Of course. With being the younger lady in the room, and ek weet jy gaan miskien bietjie be meer straightforward wees. You know? So, your opinion?
So, I completely agree with what Lucrecia is saying. Yes, it's important to stand on business. Let me say, my man stand. Now I stand on business, and I say yes, it is an important factor. Like, yes, a man is obviously taught to protect and provide, and then there's us that, like Lucrecia said, that is the backbone. And that is why I have the business that I have, is because apart from being the backbone, apart from being, some ladies maybe aren't working as a entrepreneur, maybe they do a 9-to-5. Apart from working sometimes 24/7, time and time again, you need to take care of yourself. Okay, I might not have any kids right now, but looking at things from an outside person's perspective, or from a female looking at another, and I think to myself, sometimes you just need a time out, and you just need a minute to just take care of yourself. Like, whether it means, like Lucrecia mentioned, my business, I have happy boxes, I do nails, whether it means you want a cupcake, just something so simple. So it's important to be that independent lady, stand on business, but it's also important to put yourself first in the sense where you need to take care of yourself.
Of course.
Self-care is of pure importance, and I feel like sometimes as females we forget that because we are too focused on everything else all at once. We want to be everywhere else all at once. I mean, I'm so sorry for the guys, but you score on multitask.
Yeah, of course.
I stand on business that I don't know what where men would be in this world without the females.
Of course.
So, yeah, I think I nailed it there.
Okay. Thank you so much. Any last words that you want to add, Lucretia?
No, I just want to say thank you very much, you know, for supporting our people, you know, as a whole, not just from Middlestone, but Cape Town. And I think essentially also, especially the Cape Flats, you know, that, you know, we have this outlet or this platform to promote ourselves, market our businesses. I mean, the Radio Oosterriver is the leading internet radio station. So I'm really happy that we are connected, you know, and collaborating. So yeah, thanks again, for everything.
Yes, of course. We had a great time for the month of July, actually, with all the entrepreneurs that came and represented Mrs. Plain Entrepreneur, Subhab and so forth, Carmen Gamaldin, Natalie and Aaron, and then we have Zafanaya Love, and ending off today is Charles Yastachi. So I just want to, if they are tuned in, I want to say thank you so much that they came and shared their story of resilience. I'm looking forward to great on-air collaboration shows with Mrs. Plain Entrepreneur, Subhab, and I just definitely want to thank you for your great work and resilience, Lucretia. And at the same time, I also want to wish you a happy belated birthday on air. I hope your day was fantastic. You share the same birthday.
Yes, happy birthday to you too. Your birthday to birthday
yeah, I see Rabia got the hashtag going on social media, hashtag birthday twins. So thank you for that. It was really amazing. So Chelsea and Lucretia, you guys have been amazing. Thank you so much for what you are doing, and I hope that your God is going to take your businesses and your ideas and your innovation skills and your impact that you're making and influence that you're having from one level to another level. You know, the best is yet to come. Stay steadfast even in that dark days, dark moments when we feel like, yay, ons kan nie aangaan nie, we cannot, we do not have the energy anymore, we do not have the profit anymore, we do not have the funding or the support anymore. You understand, Rome wasn't built in a day, and the walls of Jericho did not fall down on the first day. Let's Alles so sê by Radio Eersterivier, aankap as die main ding.
Thank you, Bevan, and thank you, Charles EA. Have a great day further, everyone at Radio Eersterivier.
Thank you so much, Lucretia. Thank you for joining the call. We speak soon. Chelsea, before ons gaan, kan jy gou net vir ons net sê, hoe kan ons vir jou volg en waar kan ons vir jou voor in die ander kry?
So, you can find me on Facebook and on Instagram. I almost said it, Chelsea Baked It. Yes, it's Chelsea Baked It, and it's Chelsea Nailed It. And then, the phone number. En het gaan ook maar so.
So it's fine. It was close. Hulle kan maar net search op social media, né?
Yes, they okay, can cool. search on social media.
So we're having Rabia saying there, keep on doing the great work that you do for all of us. Hashtag Bob De Toons, hashtag Lucretia Jardini en Bevan Jacobs. Dank je. Is het voor Linda Nel saying, well done, Chelsea Alana Stakkie. Chelsea nailed it. Zawad Zabar wat daar sê, great show, Bevan Jacobs, love bro, much love bro, thank you so much champion. Hy sê, Uga Chelsea, thank you for coming to Radio Eersterivier. And dan sê, business sabba pritsa. thank you everyone, Burb the Vibes, amen. And dan sê, Ula Wiggins sê, I'm so proud of you Chelsea, well done, and may your business grow from strength to strength. Ons het Zawad Zabar wat daar sê, don't be shy, dat is nou vir jou, is die station menu wat jy vroeger gemeet het. And say, ook Chelsea, personality beautiful. Meaning it, your bumwe personality.
Thank you so much for everybody that tuned in.
Thank you so much. This was the show for July, man. We're looking forward to have a great show for Women's Month. 0645369095 is that WhatsApp line. And thank you that you have been tuned into Cape Town's leading internet radio station. Radio Eersterivier, ons stasie, ons talent, ons mense. Playing out for you right now with Justin Zuster met Man van Boer.
Yo, I'm
station, our talent, and our people.
Ja, ik is Black Bond, ja. En dit is een nieuwe jaar en ik is recht. Ik het Tami sinds, ja, aan die lood en vis. Dit is een jaar waar ik met Tani en die bok in pres. Ja, van KFC zit ziek en ja, maak jou recht. En ik wil zeker maken dat is wie je bakket eet. Geld en wat is gaan niet laat die nekkers leed. Steeds hassel, ja, tot die dag breek. Toen zel is jou, ons gaan het in die nacht eet. Yo, want ik kon het niet dild. 2000 rand, ja, was net die maandse skuld. Ik kon mooi en douwe, ja, die oom blij op die bult. Maar ek het dan die jere heet voor ons verlos van die skuld. Het is like it, daar is niemand, ja, waar ik glo. Ik besef nou, dit is nou die man van boer. Ja, my blessings kom van die man van boer. Ja, my blessings kom van die man van boer. Hou ik glo in die man van boer. Glo in die man van boer. Ja, ik glo in die man van boer. Glo in die man van boer. Zij glo in die man van boer. Glo in die man van boer. Ja, ik glo in die man van boer. Ik glo in die man van boer. Maar nu die al kan ik je wel geloven, die man is lijken. Is real life hier buiten, meneer. Weapons en alles, meneer. Raak alo dangerous. Wat de oom je op je pad, safe, meneer. Die man van boer.
Our station, our talent, and our people.
Radio East River, 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 Radio East River. Onze station, onze talent, in onze mensen.